Goes the family. Welcome back to Larry's Anything Goes. Hopefully you guys are having a great and exceptional day. Happy Juneteenth. You know, it's a beautiful thing. And like I said, at the end of the day, the best way, in my personal opinion, to celebrate it is by just doing something from an economic perspective and not just going to a cookout and having fun and all that good stuff. But, you know, support African-American banks, support African-American businesses, support African-American colleges. That simple. You know, platforms on all levels, you know, from economic perspective, from a like, share, and subscribe perspective, all those different perspectives. That's the best way, in my personal opinion, to celebrate Juneteenth, not only just because of the history, but I will read over the history and just go from there. If you're not familiar, Juneteenth, which was short for June 19th, it actually marks the day when federal United States troops arrived in Galveston, Texas. Like I said, I said this before, you ever been to Galveston, beautiful city, so check it out. And they actually arrived in Galveston, Texas in 1865 to take control of the state and ensure that all enslaved people were free. The troops' arrival came a full 2.5 years after the signing of the Emancipation Proclamation. Juneteenth honors the end of slavery in the United States and is considered the longest running African-American holiday. And now, obviously, on the 17th of June, which was a couple of days ago, it was made officially a federal holiday. Confederate General Robert E. Lee had surrendered at the Appomattox Courthouse. Of course, I had to really sound that one out. 2 months earlier in the state of Virginia, my home state. But slavery had remained relatively unaffected in Texas until United States General Gordon Granger stood on Texas soil and read the General Orders Number 3. He stated, and I quote, "The people of Texas are informed that in accordance with the proclamation from the executive order of the United States, all slaves are free." And the emancipation, if you don't know, the Emancipation Proclamation was issued by President Abraham Lincoln on January 1st, 1863, and had established that all enslaved people in Confederate states in rebellion against the Union shall be then thenceforward and forever free. All right, so that's just what it is. And obviously, in reality, the Emancipation Proclamation didn't instantly free all enslaved people. You know, like anything else, like any law, things take time, but it did basically, it applied to only, this is the thing, most people don't realize, it applied only to states that were under Confederate control and not to non-slave-holding border states or rebel areas already under Union control. But, you know, for the most part, slavery was considered outlaws in other states, but I'm not going to get too in-depth in it. My mindset in 2021, having a way forward mentality, I don't like to always look back on the past. It's nice to reflect the past, whether the past is great or the past is dim. You have to use the past as your strength, you know what I mean? And that's why I said this isn't any anti-anybody thing. This is pro. Let's be positive and let's go forward and let's be able to make money moves all together and whatnot, okay? So that's what matters to me at the end of the day. So, yes, enjoy celebrating today's holiday and whatnot. Now it's officially a federal holiday, and that's great, you know? But like I said, just make it a habit of supporting supporting African-American businesses. It doesn't have to be every day. It could be once a month. And with the online world, it makes it very easy to do this. You know, hey, if you got a kid that's going to a college, maybe check out HBCU first. Or maybe contribute to the HBCUs just if you want to make donations and whatnot. Or contribute to your favorite YouTubers and whatnot. I mean, just or any podcasts. You know, there's so many levels because of the digital world that we live in nowadays. There's so many ways you can contribute by just watching or just by spending your dollars. I always call it voting with your dollars and whatnot, because that helps create community and whatnot. I mean, when people have their own community, you know, they're shopping at the stores, you know, they got the kids in the schools, they have the churches, they have the hospitals and whatnot. And you see this in a lot of major cities. People that, and they're just spending, they're not intentionally going out of the way to just spend money with their own, but they're just, it's convenient, it's who they know, and it just makes sense. So it's a cool thing. You know, I've been to various other communities and it's pretty cool. And I, you know, when you support each other, it's a beautiful thing. So I don't see anything wrong with that. You know, it's not a crazy thing whatsoever. So happy Juneteenth. Enjoy the day. Keep it positive. You know, like I said, you got one life. You better live it. I'm very happy that the world is open and just continuously try to not only make money moves, but learn as much as you can as possible. Because I'm learning as much as I can as possible. And I love the fact that I'm getting to meet a lot of people from various different backgrounds all over the country. And we're able to just have discussions and learn from each other. So, all right. Do the great three free things, family. Like, share, and subscribe. Have a great day. Don't forget to check out the online store. Thank you for the Cash Apps and the PayPal donations. It's always greatly appreciated. And as I always say, make money moves or you will live broke like a fool. As the shirt says, knowledge equals money. Money equals assets. Assets equals freedom. And so if you're not into chasing the freedom business, then you're on the wrong page. Take care, family.